everyone. I am Saurabh Jain, Vice President, Paytm. I would like to welcome you all for today's webinar. And we have three very important people in Paytm Money. We have Lijo Isaac, who is Vice President in Paytm Money, and he is managing the product management part of Paytm Money. And he has two people from his team, Saurabh Acharya and Rajesh MK, who are both AGMs product management in Paytm Money. And they all would be sharing you 10 lessons from Paytm Money growth story. So Paytm Money has grown very rapidly. In fact, even though I am a little biased because obviously I'm working in Paytm, but I would say that Paytm Money is one of the best tech products coming out of India, which has been made completely in India. And I am a very avid user of Paytm Money. So over the last 10 years, I have been mis-sell, cross-sell, lot of things from different various financial players. Just to share a very simple, interesting story, I think many of us have been mis-sell a lot of things. So in 2007, I remember, so we had that India growth story happening. I thought I should take some mutual funds. And I called a private sector bank and they sold me, it looks funny, but they sold me ULIPs saying that they are selling me mutual funds. And only after I got the policy document, I called that person. I said, why am I getting a policy document? I took mutual funds. And he said, sir, koi farak nahi padta, mutual funds and ULIP ek hi cheez hoti hai. So that was what was happening before Paytm Money. Now, fortunately, Paytm Money is there. You can buy a mutual fund just by a few clicks. And I use it myself a lot. I believe you, many of you would be also using it. If you are not using, I would advise you to use. Another interesting story just before giving to Lijo. So when Paytm Money started, one of my niece, she completed CA and she just joined a job. And I said, you should save some money by taking some mutual funds. And she said, Mamaji, is it safe or not? I said, I am using it, and obviously mutual funds are subject to market risk. But at the end of the day, we Indians need to save money. And in the current generation, it becomes easier to save using mutual funds and ETFs, etc. And Paytm Money is obviously a good way of buying mutual funds. And now we have, I think today only, if I'm correctly, Joe, we have started the share broking service also.
Yeah, we started equity trading. Yesterday we started. It has been selectively been rolled out to the users of Paytm Money.
Yes, so that is a big development. So now even buying shares has become easier. So now over to Lijo. And I am also very curious to learn about the growth hacks which Lijo and his team uses, and why they have been so successful in getting millions of users so fast. So over to Lijo.
Yeah, thanks, Saurabh. Hi, everyone who has joined in. So pleasure to share our story with the users of Paytm Money and the invitees in this seminar. I'm a part of the Paytm Money product team. So we started working on the product 3 years back. Along with me, I have two of my teammates, Saurabh and Rajesh, who will be also taking us through a few of the content in the slide. So let me start with the Paytm Money. So let me start sharing the screen, Saurabh.
Yes, you can share the screen. If there is some technical issue, let me know. Are you able to share?
No, one second. I'm not able to share.
I can stop sharing. Maybe
then. Yeah.
Now you are able to share, no?
Yeah, one second.
Yeah, we can see it. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Just hold on 1 second. Yes. Are you able to see the screen fully, Saurabh?
You can do full screen. I am able to see your screen, but it's not full screen.
Can you just give me 1 second? Can you stop the screen sharing? I'll open the PPT. Are you able to see my screen now? Saurabh? Saurabh?
No, your screen is not visible.
Are you able to see my screen now?
Yes, now it is visible.
Yeah, thank you. So Paytm Money is the fourth consumer product from Paytm. When we started Paytm Money, our objective or the mission was to ensure that we are bringing in wealth creation opportunities to millions of Indians. As Saurabh mentioned in his initial call, initial introduction, so what was happening all over India was that there were a lot of mis-selling that was happening. And there were like products that were being sold by a lot of sellers out there by promising, higher returns. And there was a lot of mis-selling that was happening. So the idea here was that we wanted to ensure that Indians have everything at the click of an app. Inside an app, within a single click, everything will be available to anyone in India. That was actually the premise with which we started. We started with mutual funds in 2018. We launched mutual funds. Then this year we launched National Pension Scheme in March. And now as Saurabh mentioned in the introduction, we are currently on the verge of launching equity. So that is being selectively rolled out to users as we move forward. So this has been a vision of the company. We'll bring wealth creation opportunities to millions of Indians. So from scratch, we have grown to 7 million users as of yesterday. So the idea is that every Indian should have an opportunity to invest and grow wealth. When we say grow wealth, they should invest in the right kind of assets, and they should be able to view how their assets are performing every day, every minute, whenever they want. That was the idea. So we are a part of the product management team at Paytm Money. So we have been involved in defining the product. We have been involved in speaking with the users. We have been involved in getting your queries and feedbacks, and also ensuring that most of them are getting implemented on the Paytm Money app. So some of these things that we'll be speaking about as we go forward in the presentation are some of the product management principles that we are following in Paytm Money. So if you look at Paytm Money now, Paytm Money over the last 22 months has become the largest investment platform in India. We have got 7 million users and it has been only 22 months since launch. Out of the 7 million users, more than 1 million users are fully KYC verified. They can invest in any of the products that I just mentioned. And we contribute to 40% of direct new SIPs that are happening in India. So every month, we contribute to approximately 40% of the new SIPs in the direct mode. So most of the users who are using our platform are from tier 2 cities. So not the top 10 cities, top 20 cities where the mutual fund penetration is almost saturated. So we are growing by expanding the market, and 50 to 60% of our users are the new users, and their first mutual fund investment happened through Paytm Money. We house more than 1 million active SIPs every month where at least one investment has happened, and 500K plus, that is like 500,000 active SIP investors are investing to us. So if you look at it, we are the largest investment platform across all the asset classes in India, the digital investment platform, and not only for mutual funds. So how did we achieve this? So if you look at it, there are like some 10, 12 lessons that we have collected from our journey over the last 3 years. The first thing is that any experience should be, any experience should be delightful and efficient. That is a premise based on which we have been working since inception. When we say delightful and efficient, let me give you an example. So if you look at it, if you think about any product or any interaction that you're having with any of the products that you are working with, there are some things which you enjoy a lot. That is called as a delightful experience. And there are some things which doesn't register in your mind. That is like an okay experience. And then there are some things which create frustration or friction. That is a substandard experience. So our motive in the product team always has been to ensure that we are having the best experience possible in any of the financial services app out here in India. So some of the things that you see out here has been defined by Rajesh and Saurabh, who has been a part of the team. So if you look at the first screenshot that is out here in the presentation, it's the portfolio graph that we have been showing to users. So if you look at the portfolio graph, you can actually see that it is actually it's a visual presentation that we are giving to our users. And who doesn't want to see his money growing every month or every day or every year? So that has been the premise based on which we had built that graph. And if you look at it, when we launched it, most of the apps out there, which are like traditional banking apps, they would just give a value with a percentage of return with an up arrow or down arrow. That is the kind of the experience that they were offering. We tried making it more visual because we felt that that is one of the areas where the users will feel more delightful whenever they see that their investment is growing or their investment is coming down. So that is one of the, it looks very basic, but these are some of the features that we thought through, which we thought that would be enjoyable to the users and through which, we have been able to attract more users. So Rajesh, you may want to speak about the SIP.
Hey, hi. Hello, everyone. Rajesh here. So thank you, Job. So regarding the delightful and efficient thing, right? So one of those two things which we are really proud on what we did is with respect to SIPs. When any user wants to create an SIP, right, we give him multiple options like scheme, date, amount, and any other things. But there's one thing that we did really well is making a user to select a particular date. So these dates, right, are based on the past returns of that particular scheme. So this is something like in the past few days, this is on this particular date, this particular scheme made so much, gave us so much returns. So trying to tell the user that if he had invested on 7th of every month, his returns will probably be so much. So this is something that we really did well and received a great positive feedback. And there's another thing that we did is with respect to timeline on what was happening with respect to a particular investment or a transaction. Whenever a user makes a transaction, right, until now it was a complete black box to the user, as in he wasn't knowing what was happening at the back end. So what we made is we just exactly replicated the steps that is happening at the back end on what happens once the money gets invested, when user makes a payment and what happens to it when it goes to the back end. That we started putting it as a timeline to the user, which it was a very delightful experience to the user. So Saurabh, you want to take the next one? Like Saurabh, you know?
Yes, so I can like speak about few things which we have done in like onboarding as well on top of like what Rajesh has told. So in onboarding, like we found that onboarding is like pretty like long process, and people lost track of their KYC, that at which step their KYC is lying, and like whether the verification is done or like what thing is not getting verified. So as Rajesh told that as for transaction, we tried to replicate all the backend steps upfront to the customer so that he can get some transparency of his transaction status. Same kind of thing we tried to do in KYC as well. So in KYC as well, we just like bifurcated all the KYC steps into smaller steps and showed it to the customer upfront on the app. And what helped was that customer got the real-time update of his status. And along with that, we did a very strong tech and ops integration. So by that, what happened was that we were able to give our customer a real-time update that in how much time is KYC will be verified. So on our app now, we are telling the customer that in 30 minutes of KYC will be verified. And by that strong tech and ops integration, we are able to achieve that number. So like more than 90% of the KYCs we are able to verify within 30 minutes. So that is something very delightful to the customer, wherein like he is getting that transparent view of his entire KYC journey, which is pretty long upfront on his UI.
Correct. Thanks, Saurabh. I'll go to the second lesson. The second lesson is about creating a minimum lovable product. So when we actually say minimum lovable product, what it implies is that you need to create an emotional connect with the customer. So if you look at some of the Twitter comments that we have been getting, so if you look at it, even Saurabh Jain, who is our host, he had commented on this when we had launched in September 2018. And he has been one of our like most ardent customers who is giving a lot of feedback. So if you look at it, the way in which we approach the product and the product discovery and the problem definition on what the customer's experience should be, that was actually a marked change when compared to most of the other products out there. including fintechs, including traditional banks, including most of the other digital providers out there. And this was like a whiff of fresh air for a lot of users who started interacting with our app. And primarily, we have been getting more users through word of mouth. Most lot of users are not aware about Paytm Money through advertisements. They became aware about Paytm Money through their friends or relatives who have been using this product. So the best measurement of a minimum lovable product is the emotional connect that the user is able to make with your product, and then him referring the product to some of the other users who come and use it. So this is something that we have been very fortunate to be, primarily because a lot of users still reach out to us with their feedbacks and they consider the product as their own. So getting that emotional approach and that getting that emotional response is something that as product managers have to be really careful about. Rather than doing an okay work on a lot of the features, they should try to ensure that it is delightful and it creates an emotional touch with the user. This is the second lesson. The third thing is about ensuring that rather than working on a lot of things and doing a substandard job, we should ensure that we should get some things very, very right. For example, in our case, what we have been doing is that there are some features on which we have iterated the screens almost like hundreds of times, including the backend, including the UI, including various touch points out there. For example, one of the things that we worked on, there is a page called Transaction History. Which was actually one of the primary sources of complaints for us when we launched the product. As the backend was not so transparent on when the transactions were happening, how long it is taking, et cetera, et cetera. So that page is being owned by Rajesh, who is also speaking in this session. And his team would have made at least 100 plus iterations out there doing multiple A-B testing to check what will reduce the number of touch points of a customer with the customer service and whether we can actually solve those issues without without customer calling customer service or raising a query to the customer service. So Rajesh, you want to add to that?
I think so. We, like you just said, there were too many iterations that was done over there. So at the beginning, when we started off with it, it was a basic plain page, basic timeline which had given when the transaction was made and just the basic details. Moving ahead, we realize that, okay, so there are certain things that the user actually wants to know and what is happening, as in he wants to know when the unit got allotted, when will the payment be done, if in case the payment fails, when will it be refunded and such particular things. So we started putting those messages on the app. And so what this reflected in, this immediately decreased the number of CS queries that we were getting. A lot of people, instead of reaching out to the CS, they started seeing on the app and they got to know what they wanted to know. So this is one of those things that people usually, many of the products actually misses out, but we somehow managed to pull it off.
Thanks, Rajesh. The next thing is about the kind of advertisement or the kind of marketing that you have to do. So what we fundamentally believe in Paytm Money is that if your product is really good and if the product is able to give delightful experiences, then you won't have to do marketing by paying money. Your users will be doing the marketing for yourself. That is something that has happened over the last 3 years. And if you look at the pace at which we have been adding users, a million bucket every time, we have 7 million users now. That has been always reducing, primarily because the word of mouth has been the primary driving factor for us. Whenever we were launching new products, and we always listen to users and ensure that whatever the users were asking for are the things that we are working on. And it's all about ensuring that you are fulfilling the user needs for a product manager, and you are listening to the customer problem. So an extension of what I told till now is that we worry about what needs to be created and not when needs to be created. So it's about defining it in the right way, the customer problem, and trying to productize it in a way that it is delightful for the customer, as few of the last examples that we showed you. So when we thought about that SIP date selector, we knew that is going to be a touch point where the user will be lost, because most of the users who are coming and using Paytm Money are new users who have never been you have never been investing in mutual funds. So how to make the experience as easy and as seamless as possible? So as PMs, we should always worry about what we are creating and not when we are creating. So even if it takes some time, we need to ensure that we are creating it in the right way so that the delight of the user is what we are always focusing on. So one of the hallmarks of a good PM or a great PM is how the PM is treating the other team members within the organization as well. So one of the things that we are very proud about Paytm Money is the fact that we have been able to reduce the customer ticket percentage when our transactions has been going up to a significant percentage. So all the PMs work very closely with the customer service team, listen to their feedback, and then try to ensure that most of those feedbacks are incorporated within our app so that there is no reward from the customers whenever they are having a problem at a later stage because we have already automated it. So this has been the trend of the percentage of customer tickets that has been raised in Paytm Money. While our transactions has increased by almost like 100x, while our customer ticket percentage has come down by almost 90%. So Saurabh, do you want to touch base upon this?
Yes, Lijo. So this is something which we all like worked very hard upon to bring up the customer queries down. So as you can see in the graph, like earlier, like as Lijo mentioned that we were having customer queries as double digit in terms of percentage of total number of transactions done. But now like we have brought it down to single digit percentage. So what we have done to solve all this thing is like we have worked very closely with the support team, wherein like for each and every issue, we tried to slice and dice to see like whether that issue is falling in certain category. And then like we spoke to a lot of the customers directly to understand the problem that how they landed up in that issue. And then as a part of our like product culture, what we have done is that like we started taking up the issues which were like occurring again and again into our sprints. So whenever we plan our sprint, what we have done is that we have ensured that at least like 2-3 frequent customer queries which are happening, that we solve, or like we give a better experience so that customer don't raise a query for that thing. So that's how like we have tackled this customer support issue numbers.
So as PMs, we believe that we have to work as close to customers as possible. So when we say as close to customers as possible, we do focus group discussions, we do various studies, we do surveys with customers, we do NPS. But in addition to that, we also work very actively with the customer service teams to ensure that the kind of issues that are being created are either resolved or automated so that it won't happen again and again. So that is an exercise that we have been doing. And one of the reasons for our rapid growth has been the customer focus and ensuring that we are responding to queries as fast and as early as possible. And if a customer has a query, that is the same is not repeated for another customer at a later stage. So there are some queries that we are still working on. As we are expanding and as we are reaching to 7 million customers, some of those queries which were like smaller buckets in the initial stages of our growth now has become larger bucket. So our focus is on those queries now, and hopefully we'll be able to bring it to less than 1%, which is our eventual aim. So the next thing is about what are the metrics that we are tracking when we are progressing with the product. So when we actually started the product, so one of our success metrics was the number of folios that were being created, because the mutual fund industry in India looks at the number of folios as a success metric. But what we realized at a later stage was that any user can create any number of folios and there is no filter on that. So we realized that it's a vanity metrics and we no longer measure it. So if you look at the number of folios that are being created, then it's like multiple, and we may be creating the largest number of folios every month in India. But we treat that as a vanity metrics. So as we move forward, initially the success metrics for the transaction team was the number of transactions that were occurring. Then after 3 months, it changed to number of transactions which were successful. Then after 6 months, it changed to number of transactions which were successful and which was updated for the user within like a certain number of days. And as we go forward, the tracking metrics keep on evolving. So this is essential, primarily to ensure that you are focusing on the right kind of effort to solve the customer problems that are happening, and also ensuring that you're always on your toes to ensure that your product is best in class when compared to most of your other competitors as well as the other players in the market. So these are some of the metrics that we measure internally. So if you look at the first metric, that shows the number of days in which the Paytm Money is able to do a 100 crore of AUM. So if you see that in the first graph, that metric has been coming down drastically. So initially we used to take whatever we used to take in the initial days. We now take almost like 1/10 of that to do 100 crores, which means that more customers are coming in and their average ticket sizes are also going up. The second is a measure of the time taken for the users, 1 million users to invest in Paytm Money. So if you look at it, that metric has also been coming down, and we are currently in a hockey stick growth. And when we compare to other players out there, so we achieved 1 million SIPs in almost 1 year, while it took 25 years for State Bank of India, or almost 20 years for other players who are out there who are not completely digital. So which is also a hallmark of our success. So we always look at how these metrics can be shortened. So if it took 1 year for 1 million SIPs in the last version of our app, in this year, can we actually do it in almost half the time? That is something that we always aspire. And our benchmarks are only internal, which we are supposed to meet. We take a lot of inspiration from our users and we move forward. And if you look at some of our other metrics, we never had a chargeback or a fraud case in the last 22 months of our operation, primarily because of the strong internal procedures that we have. And similarly, our success rate in upload or success rate in the KYC upload to various regulatory systems, etc., is almost like 100%. So this is something that, all of us at Paytm Money and product team are really proud about. And these are some things that we have been working on to ensure that we are improving it further. So once we reach 100%, we ensure that it remains as it is, and then we move to other metrics which can be optimized. So the next thing is about team dynamics. So in a lot of product companies, product managers, especially at the entry level, they raise concerns about the friction that happens with the design team, with the engineering team, etc. So in Paytm Money, it is a harmonious effort. And what we do there is to ensure that we always manage by asking the right questions and ensure that, we are asking the right questions, which gives the perspective of the problem to the person who is working on that. So everybody in Paytm Money is involved in defining the customer solution as well as in identifying what is the correct problem which we are trying to solve. So this is something that everybody in product management team follows. And the next thing is about making your problem their problem. So it may sound a little bit ironic, but Rajesh, you may want to speak about Pulse.
Sure. So make your problem their problem. So Pulse is actually something that we built for the AMCs and actually not for the users. So mutual fund industry is majority driven, it's an operation driven thing, right? So which means there's a lot of hops and more hops, which means there'll be a lot of drop-offs at every stage. So the thing is, what we wanted to do is we put the entire thing. So Pulse is nothing but a dashboard which will show you stage-wise where a particular transaction is. We summarize it, we give the entire description, and AMC-wise, as in the asset management company-wise, and we give a login to them, and we just provide the entire report to them. So this way, what happens is, number one, we will be building a very good relationship with the AMCs, and also the AMCs will exactly know where they have, if there is a mistake or anything to do with the operations, they'll know where to correct, where to improve. So it's not just about that. Pulse also, what we did is we got a lot of insights through Pulse. Other information is like, which particular scheme is doing pretty well, what are the average ticket sizes of a particular scheme, and which city, say something like Bangalore, a lot of people who are investing are through Bangalore for this particular scheme, which are such good insights, right? So a lot of, on Paytm Money itself, we have a lot of tier 2, tier 3 cities, people investing from tier 2 and tier 3 cities. Such insights was given on Pulse to the AMCs. This is something that the AMCs hadn't seen earlier, if I'm not sure. I think, if I'm right, AMCs wouldn't have seen this earlier from other platforms. And this way, they were able to improve their numbers as well. They would be knowing what the problem, what kind of problems the users are facing, where should they improve.
So primarily, we were always telling AMCs that these are the challenges that we have with your transactions. But AMCs were of the belief that their operations are super efficient and there are no issues at all. So what we did for that was to ensure that we created a platform, and every day at 9 o'clock, a mail goes to most of the senior stakeholders in AMC listing out the issues with the transactions that has been, that has happened the previous day. So once it started going to each of these stakeholders, it became really transparent and they started working on those transactions. So if you look at a mutual fund transaction, so once you make the transaction, there are multiple entities that are involved to ensure that you are getting the right, you are getting the units at the time in the, with the correct NAV, and you know, there are like multiple other factors also which are being checked. So it's a complex transaction. It's not a simple buy transaction. So it has to also ensure that all the regulatory requirements are also being fulfilled. So there are like multiple checks out there. Now, because of all these checks which were happening in between, so there were like a lot of cases in the initial days when the transactions were delayed. And when we used to tell our asset management companies that the transactions were delayed, they were of the opinion that no, it is happening, you know, it's like a miscommunication. So once this got launched, you know, we were able to move that successful transactions from 97% to almost 99%, primarily with the support of asset management companies, which understood that not all the transactions are happening as they were assuming. And there were like challenges in lot of transactions, lot of mutual fund transactions that were happening, not only through Paytm Money, but through a lot of other players as well. And this tool has helped to automate the processes for a lot of AMCs out there. So this is about ensuring that we focus on the right kind of problems. So our idea always has been to ensure that we are doing some things really right in the sense that there is like undivided focus that goes to few of the user interactions and few of the backend challenges which happens out there. Rajesh, you may want to go through this. So this is a page where we do a lot of A/B testing. And the success metric is the number of people who are viewing the page, how many of those them are reaching out to customer service, how many of them are having other challenges, etc., etc. So this page would have gone through at least 100 plus iterations over the last 3 years, because this is the page where a user reaches once he does the transaction. So this is the moment of truth for a mutual fund transaction. After paying the money, once he makes the transaction, till the units are allotted, most of the users visit this page. So Rajesh, you may want to take the audience through this.
Sure. So like Lijo said, right? So once a user makes an investment, right? So there would be some gap on when the units would be allotted. Until then, the only question the user will ask is, where is my money, right? So until you give him a clarity on where what is happening, so the user will always be like, well, what would have happened, because obviously it's a new platform which he hasn't seen, everything is online. So that is where this thing comes into picture. As soon as he makes a transaction, he makes an investment, goes to a PG, makes an investment, and the next step, what happens? So this is the complete timeline on what happening. Say something like, you can see the mutual fund payment. As soon as it is done, that means we would have received the money, we show that as done. And the next one is, we say that order is placed with AMC. Here, what happens is, if something is rejected, or this is where that will get the user to be a little more curious and lead to CS issues. Once you have these things, right? So these are the things that will actually completely reduce your CS issues. Not just that. And we also filled in with other details. When the transaction has actually become a success, you'll be knowing with what NAV, what date, what time. Such things is something that we are, we multiple iterations went through it. So if it's, there are different, I think Lijo and myself would have sat for more than 10 days to just complete this particular page. Agreed, Lijo?
Yeah, correct. And then iterations later as well.
Multiple iterations.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. Great. So I think we are almost at the end of presentation. So Saurabh, back to you.
Yes. So just sharing, so as part of Build for India, we try to give free payment gateway, just 1 minute. We try to give free payment gateway to the startups. So I will just show that and then I will switch to Q&A round. So we will do Q&A, but just before Q&A, I want to tell you about the free payment gateway offer which we are giving as part of Paytm Build for India. So Paytm Build for India is an initiative to help startups. Like for example, today's session is an aim to bring a industry insider like Lijo in touch with the audience and share his best practices. But besides the best practices, we also give some of the Paytm products free of cost or the early access to products if they are closed products. So Paytm Build for India plan for startups is a very good plan. You get monthly transactions worth 1 lakh rupees for 0% commission for 12 months. So anybody can take this plan. It just need to be a firm or a startup or a company. So I am sharing my email address in the chat panel. So you can connect with me. And just 1 minute, I will just share my email address. So I'm sharing my email address with all the attendees. If somebody needs free payment gateway plan, you can write to me with the name of the startup. So I'm sharing what we all need. So name of startup, the contact details, and the URL of the website or app. So we require these three things. Also, you can reach out to me on social media as at SKJ Saurabh or at Paytm Build India. And last thing which I would like to share before asking questions is the so there is this new program which we have started called Paytm Mini App. So many startup founders used to ask me that is there any way of doing a tie-up with Paytm, having our service icon, our website live on Paytm. And now we have started this based on the feedback. So you can integrate your mobile website or a PWA with Paytm. So like you see, if you open Paytm app, you can see Paytm Money icon. Although Paytm Money is a separate app, but you can go to Paytm Money from Paytm. So similarly, like not exactly same, but similarly, we are having this Paytm Mini App program where you can integrate your mobile website or your progressive web app within the Paytm app, similar to this screenshot, which you can see. We have 140 million monthly active users. So as soon as you go live, you will have obviously thousands of customers, maybe even depending upon your category, maybe even millions of customers, because so many people are live on Paytm every day. And you can join the likes of Domino's, Pizza, Ghana, Booking.com, etc. in this. So you can go to business.paytm.com/paytm-mini-program. And for this also, you can write to me on my email address. If this is an invite-only program, but we generally try to help the smaller startups. And if your startup is having a good service, we will definitely like to have this in the Paytm Mini App program. So now I am starting the question and answers. So first question which I would like to ask Lijo would be, as a product manager, what has been your role in Paytm Money? Although you have shared a lot, but I would like to focus more on like when it all started, Parveen Jadhav was the first CEO and when he started, and you must be having a very small team. How was it recruiting? How was it thinking about a product? Because today it looks very simple, but at that time, because I still, if you go to the websites of, I don't want to name the competitors, but if you go to the websites of PSUs and even private sector banks, they are very, very complicated. So how were you able to design and how you were able to talk to all the AMCs and all and create a very seamless system in the first year, if you can focus on that? You are on mute, I think. Vijay, you are
either. The role of a product manager in any organization, sorry, be it in Paytm or anywhere else, is to ensure that they are delighting the customers in ways which adds value to the business. When I mean adds value to the business, it's about bringing the users or adding to the revenue. So that's a role if you look at it. As you said, lot of these financial sites are like very complex to use. Primarily because they have been built for regulators and not for users. And the value that the product manager brings in out there is to ensure that this complexity is simplified. so that anybody from say any part of India, be it from any of the states, can come and transact. So that's the value that a product manager brings in. As you correctly said, when we started mutual fund, I would call it as a first world tech problem, primarily because mutual fund as an industry, it's an industry that has been that has not adapted itself to change. So some of the AMCs and some of the other entities are still using COBOL and things like that. So it was tough working with them initially. But once they understood our intent is to ensure that we will be bringing in more customers, and we wanted to simplify it for users, most of the entities, including regulator, which is SEBI, have been very receptive to our ideas. And they also helped us to ensure that a lot of items are simplified for the users who are transacting not only through Paytm Money, but through a lot of our competitors as well. I hope that answers your question.
That's a good answer. Would Saurav and Rajesh, would you like to add anything to that?
Yes, so I'll just say that, as Lijo said, there were a lot of competitors there, and a lot of the products which were already there were pretty complex to use. So on top of worrying about how regulators are there, what the compliance are there, we also worked very hard on identifying the actual customer and their problems, that where the customers are actually struggling in all the existing products. So we tried to identify the actual problem, the actual root cause, and then gradually we started rolling out the solutions which solved one problem at a time, but for a larger audience, which was much more bigger pain point that we solved first, and then gradually we started solving smaller pain points. So yes, it's a long journey which we have took to make this.
And just one, I'm chipping in with a very small question. So you started with just mutual funds, which was, I think, most companies don't start with such a small product. They generally start with all a suite of services. So was it a minimum viable product which you had in mind, or was it more you didn't have bandwidth to do anything else and you thought that that is something which you would have to start with?
Saurav, not really. So most of the companies doesn't start with mutual funds because mutual fund is something that is not very digital friendly. So we have made it digital friendly, and we have made the path easy for a lot of the other people who will be coming behind it. So we think that a lot of the other startups which are working on fintech problems will be launching with mutual funds. So we see, if you actually look at our vision, which I presented in the initial slide, we want to ensure that we become the all-in-one investment app for any asset that is available for investment in India. So mutual fund is the first step. Then we launched NPS, then we launched equity. There'll be other products also which will be going forward. And anybody in India or outside India for that matter, after a few years, will be able to do all their investments through Paytm Money in a delightful way. That has been our objective, and we have been marching towards it with the equity launch also that happened yesterday.
Okay. So next question is, do you believe in growth hacking? Because you were able to grow so fast. Within 2 years, you have reached 7 million users. And so do you believe in growth hacking? You shared some things, but were there some growth hacks which you used, or was it broadly because of the brand as well as the user experience, everything worked well?
So everything worked well. So we are, we measure all the metrics that happens out there. So rather than growth hacking, we will actually call it, growth marketing. So for us inside Paytm Money, marketing is a retired word. We call it growth. So we have not spent money on marketing like a lot of the other fintechs out there. Primarily, our growth has been through word of mouth and solving for the right customer problems out there. Maybe Saurav can add more to it because he looks at the initial part of the funnel where most of the users are coming in. Saurav, you want to add to that?
Yes. So I'll say that we don't do any growth hack as such, but whatever we presented, Lijo presented in those 10 points. So those itself are growth things. So if we do those things correctly, right, and rightly, for example, if you just know that who your customer is, if you know that what you're solving, and if you like manage things efficiently, that itself like increase your velocity in terms of shipping the features, and that also ensures that what you're shipping will like it will be beneficial to the end customer. So I'll say that those itself, like those things were small things, but helped us in growing very quickly, because that helped us to become very much efficient in our entire like product shipment cycle.
Okay. So the last question before I open it up to audience. Audience is asking a lot of questions. So how can an unfunded startup reach a million users? Because there are people in the audience who are unfunded, who have the vision to reach 1 million users. And obviously they would feel that we had Paytm brand with us, and obviously Paytm is a well-funded startup. So you can add on that. Just before that, I would like to myself also add, because although you people have been working hard, but I have seen Vijay and I have listened to some of his internal talks on Paytm Money. So what I have realized is that he's having a very clear vision that most of Indians are right now not having access to good financial services on apps. So what I'm seeing is that he is focusing now Paytm on bringing a complete suite of financial services. So Paytm Money being the investment related app, and within Paytm we are adding insurance and a lot of other features, lending, etc. The other thing which I have seen about your that panel where you show that 2 days pending for allotment of units. So once Vijay was telling on that, so I was sitting and he was sharing with some other person, and he said that if something takes 4 days, you cannot expect a customer to wait for 4 days and every day he's seeing the app and he's seeing aaj bhi nahi aaya, aaj bhi nahi aaya. So he said ideally you should show how much time they should wait, and you cannot say that you have to wait for 4 or 5 days. You should break it down in steps, and every step should be 1 or 2 days, so that person has curiosity, they can come to the app, and then obviously they can see the status. So this what I've seen is this thinking starts in Paytm from the top, and that's the reason for good user experience. What I feel is that some of our competitors are missing that, I think, because what I've seen is that Vijay and initially Parveen also was very good in product management themselves also. So they, I think, fully supported you all whenever you build something. So now over to the question, how can an unfunded startup reach a million users fast?
Yeah, so I would say the short answer is to create a stellar product. So if the product experience is really great, then you don't have to worry about users. The users who are using your product will bring in more users. So, but you need to have enough funding to ensure that the product never goes down and you are able to pay all your server costs.
And Saurabh and Rajesh, can you add?
Yes, so I'll just say, like, doing things rightly will ensure that your product becomes pretty like good and seamless for all the users, and then like word of mouth is enough to give you rapid growth, because that marketing funding can just give you like a rapid boost at some point in time, but if the product is not good, then that growth won't be sustainable. So having a solid, robust product is good enough to get that growth.
Correct. Just one. Saurabh said, when you're actually spending marketing dollars, what you're essentially doing is that you're grabbing the attention of the users. So if somebody comes in with more marketing dollars, they will be able to get more attention. So essentially, that's not the sustainable road to go through. See, Rajesh, you are going through, you are actually speaking.
Yeah, I was just adding one point, as in always focus on the customer's problem. The problem is always to identify the actual problem. The solution is relatively simple, but if you identify the correct problem and solve it, I think that is the product.
Okay. So now I am asking the audience questions. So this is not directly related to product management, but I think you should answer it. So Krishan Kumar is asking that he is opening SIPs and all, and say if tomorrow we close down Paytm Money app. I believe you don't plan to do that. But what is it that if something happens to Paytm Money app, where will his money go? As far as I believe, like you can correct me, So the money goes directly to the mutual funds, and as a like a mutual fund holder using Paytm money, I have seen that I get the statement from the NSDL also and from the Correct. Mutual fund companies also. So the money is there in mutual fund, and you can if Paytm money is also not there, you can directly go to the AMC and get the you can sell the units and get the money. I hope Lijo, I am correct.
Yeah, that is correct.
I think he's also asked about the mutual fund company closing, which is okay. It's the rarest of the rarest thing that's going to happen. But anyway, to answer the question, if that is the case, the money will be returned to the user basis the latest net asset value.
So then Ketan Deshpande has asked a question. To show gain and loss definitely adds delight for the user, but there could be hundreds of small features. How do you zero down on what to include in the product and what to leave out?
So the idea is that you need to understand what is the customer problem that the feature is able to solve. And if that is actually a band-aid or is it like a huge wound? So whenever we are working on any of the enhancements to the product, not only features, but enhancements to the current things as well. What we ensure is that we are looking at, fixing the wounds first and then go for the band-aid. So we have a prioritization metrics, which is almost like a RISE prioritization. We look at, the effort, we look at the confidence, we look at the impact. And based on that only, we decide on what to work on next. And the product managers at Paytm Money has their hands full always. As we are adding new products, and as there are a lot of challenges that are there with our current products as well.
There is another question which is specifically for Forab Acharya. Huh. So Gaurav Kumar is asking that you spoke about transparency in onboarding. How do you make onboarding frictionless?
Yes. So that is a biggest challenge, I'll say, like in all the financial industries, that every customer who wants to invest has to go through a painful process of onboarding, which is pretty lengthy and with full of friction. So we at Paytm Money, like we are trying to make it frictionless as much as possible. So I'll just like tell what all things we are doing in order to make it frictionless. So first of all, like we try to understand the customer's pain point, that where the maximum drop happens, that which step customer finds it pretty difficult to complete, or which step customer takes more time to complete. Then like we just pinpoint on that problem and try to make the UI UX along with design team seamless, so that customer can quickly do that step on the UI. Along with that, what we've done in our onboarding is that throughout the onboarding, we have added a lot of guidelines for the customers, so that they get to understand that if you're asking for a particular document, then that document looks like what, and what are the acceptable form of that document. So all that information which we are accommodating in our onboarding process helps the customer to complete that quickly. Then also like we are having off the app communication channels, like our emails and notifications, where also time to time we try to nudge the customer and explain them that how they can quickly like finish up fewer steps which are there in the onboarding pretty quickly. So yes, all these things help us to make it frictionless.
Okay. So there is a question by Rohit Prajapati, how to reach early adopters? So during your initial days, you were focusing on early adopters or you were focusing on the mass market? I would like to add this line on top of the question. And then the question, how to reach early adopters?
So during the early days, so we had a early access program where users could come and apply for becoming a user of Paytm Money. So we started this program almost like 7 months before launching the actual mutual fund app. So by the time we launched app, we almost had like 1 million users. So in addition to that, we also went for the normal forums like Product Hunt, to Reddit, et cetera, to promote the app as well. But once we launched the app, it soon became, viral and really popular, and more users came in. So the primary input for early adopters was through the early access program.
Okay. Would anybody like to add? Saurabh or Rajesh? Okay. So Chetan is asking, tell about shares in Paytm Money. I believe that he's asking about share broking in Paytm Money.
Correct. So we have launched it yesterday, and that is also going through an early adopter program now. So in case you want access, you should surely apply. And then we are testing all the platforms now, and soon we'll be rolling it out to all the users. So currently it's limited, the number of users whom we are enrolling each day, but we are trying to increase the capacity as we move forward.
So there is a question. So these kind of questions generally come these days. So how I think this is more of a question for me than you all. How are you planning to tide over anti-China funded affair that's happening right now? So I would like to clarify one thing that, right now Paytm is more than 16% owned by Vijay Shekhar Sharma, our founder. So Vijay is 100% Desi Indian. He studied till 12th in Hindi medium school. And so he loves to speak his native language. And he says ki hame India ko America ki tarah banana chahiye. So he is more very focused on that. And I believe that most of the competitors, if you see in all the big banks, etc., have a lot of FII holding. So there are a lot of foreign investors. So there is no 100% pure Indian company. I don't think even PSU banks are 100% Indian these days. Most have FII holding. So that is there. The other thing is that if you see a lot of competitors, most people have funding from various countries. So we have funding from Warren Buffett's company. We have funding from SoftBank, which is based in Japan. So it's not a China-specific funding. And last but not least, I believe that it's more about what you have in your heart. So I am not once in my whole life I have ever felt ki I am working in. I have always felt ki it's an Indian company. And that's why we have this Build for India program, which I am leading. And when you open Paytm Money app, you always see Built for India. So that is so Indianness is in the heart. In the age of globalization, we cannot say that this country cannot give money, that country cannot give money. My own personal take. So then the next question is, why did Paytm Money build integrations with individual AMCs, spending a lot in the process and not ride on platforms like BSC Star Mutual Fund? Can you elaborate on the decision?
We had evaluated other platforms as well, but our internal consensus was that that platforms were not at a level of experience that we want to offer to users. And if you look at the user growth after that, you can see that we are much bigger than any of the platforms that use it out there. So we wanted to ensure that there was like less hope between us and the user and the AMCs. And this direct integration was the best route to go for that.
So basically this was faster.
Yeah, it was not faster. If you had gone through that route, we would have been able to launch the product. Yeah, faster for the user. So the go-to-market would have been much faster if you had gone through that route, but we would have to compromise on the experience. So we decided to go through that VC start.
So another question is, why is equity launch enrollment limited? Is it a pilot to test waters or is there some other reason? One thing I would like to add before you can answer it is that, so this is a general practice in product management. This is lean startup methodology that you test with a few percentage of users. Facebook, Google, everybody does this. And Lijo can add more details, but this is a very general practice. So this is not something why we are doing it, but Lijo can add.
Yeah, the same reason. The idea is that it's a new product. So we want to ensure that anybody who comes in have a very good experience. So we are selectively rolling it out to the users as we move forward. Within next few days or months, everybody who has applied for access will be getting the access. So it's not about how soon you're getting it. It's about once you get it, whether you're having the right experience. So we are also still testing. Every system is new. So the user data is being propagated. So we will increase the capacity as we move forward. We had done the same thing for mutual funds, same thing for NPS, same thing for equity, and you know, a lot of other products as well.
So there are a lot of questions, but due to lack of time, I will stick to 2-3 questions. Uh-huh. So a question is, will this share platform would be rolled for Android and iOS, and how can somebody apply for this equity offer, or they would have to wait till you add them?
Yeah, so currently we are offering it for Android, but the iOS platform should be rolled out in next few weeks. And you can apply for early access in Android currently, and it will be also open in iOS once we open it out. So it should happen in this month.
So somebody is asking if this person is an undergraduate student interested in becoming a product manager. So can you tell this person how he can become a product manager? The other thing is that there are a lot of unfunded startups who cannot afford good product managers. Can you tell their founders how they can become a product manager, semi-product manager themselves? Because what I've realized is that most of the unfunded startups cannot afford to have good product managers. So I always tell them that it is better to become 50% founder and 50% product manager, because I see that in Vijay also. And I saw Praveen Jadhav also when he was CEO. So he used to focus a lot on product. So maybe you can add how somebody can learn product management, both from the founder's point of view as well as from a student point of view.
See, from a student point of view, the best thing to do is to try building something on your own, or maybe by collaborating with other people. So once you start building something on your own, you may get a sense of whether it is your cup of tea. And if you really enjoy whatever you are doing, then you should surely continue with product management. For founders in startups, inherently they have to create products to get users and revenue, and they have to be product managers. And in most of the startups, the founder is the first product manager. So Rajesh, Saurabh, you may want to add to that, especially from the student perspective and the founder perspective.
For me, for student perspective, I can just basis my experience. I started as a software developer. And instead of being on this part of the table, I thought, okay, I should see how it works over there. And that is how that interested me. So product is nothing to do with product, right? It has business, product, operations, multiple things, design, engineering. So that is something that actually that is something that I liked. As in, you would be communicating with almost all the teams that would be there in a particular organization. That is where I started liking the product, and I just got it like that. So it actually depends on the interests, or the best way to try it out is be a product manager for a while as soon as you get in, and then see.
So Sabir is asking, very nicely done presentation. My question is regarding the page after transaction is done. As you said, you did more than 100 iterations to make it perfect. So basically that kind of process what kind of process you use to test, and how do you choose?
So in simple, you could just say it as A/B testing for this particular page, right? Like, we went through a lot of CS issues. Actually, we read through a lot of CS issues until we were sure that this is stabilized and people are actually not raising any other requests. So the best way to get a feedback is how many CS issues that you have that you would be solving. So if you are solving those, it's as solving the customer's problem for that particular product. So this particular iteration, whatever you have mentioned and whatever we have mentioned, right, is going through a lot of CS issues from phase one. We did one thing, we went through the CS issues, and we thought, okay, something else is missing. So we again redid it and we added more information. And that's how we got to the stage what we are at now.
Okay, so... another question which Hemant Pite has asked. So he's saying, was delightful and efficient your definition of done?
Saurabh, can you?
Was delightful and efficient your definition of done? like whenever a feature is delightful and efficient, you would say that it is done, or
not really. So if you are making your feature delightful and efficient, there are a lot of other players who are trying to make it even more delightful. So it's actually a tough game. So it's not done. So we always improvise on the feature. So one of the metrics that Saurabh is owning is the onboarding funnel. And he has launched so many features which took that, which has almost doubled that percentage over like last 1.5 years. So not features, primarily he has done a lot of optimizations. And each of those optimizations add a drop of delight. So it's never a, it's never done after being delightful and efficient. It's always work in progress. Yeah, Rajesh, you may want to add there. Saurabh, you also.
No. First you make it done, and then make it even more delightful.
Yeah, I'll also add on to that it's not a, there is no silver bullet solution here. So we just keep on discussing among ourselves and the team that to make like a product is a lead bullet solution. So you need to keep on like hitting or firing the bullets to make that product like finally. So it's not done like just by doing like one feature or something. You just need to keep on iterating it again and again.
So I believe we have exhausted all the questions. So. One person is asking, will the deck be shared with us? Lijo, would you be publishing this anywhere?
Yeah, it's there in that video channel, Saurabh, that Paytm for Business.
So, okay. So, basically, generally, we publish our Built for India webinars on Paytm for Business Facebook page and Paytm for Business YouTube channel. So, you can see the presentation there. We would not be sharing this PPT as such. But you can obviously see the video again at Paytm for Business YouTube channel as well as the Facebook page. So I truly enjoyed the listening to all three of you. I learned a lot about product management. So what I have felt over the years is that India ke andar jo sabse badi problem hai, that is lack of product management. And whenever I visit some of the net banking sites of the even private sector banks, I always feel inke paas wo product managers kyun nahi hai jo Paytm ke paas hai. And the reason why I have switched completely for my new investments to product Paytm money is that only. Because you just need to click. Mere saath to in fact, last year what happened, it was so easy to invest in mutual funds. I got habitual to invest in mutual funds. I had to stop myself to invest in mutual funds because you had to just press two clicks and you could buy. So I believe more things can improve, and my only wish is that more people learn product management, and even the government apps and the other app for citizens become as easy to use as Paytm money, and the founders are able to learn growth hacks and able to grow their startups so that we have thousands of big startups in India. So with that, I would like to end the session, and I truly enjoyed the session.
Yeah, thank you, Saurabh. Thank you for hosting us.
Thanks, Saurabh. Everyone.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Saurabh, for hosting us.
Thank you, everyone. Thanks, Saurabh.
Bye.
Thanks a lot, everyone. Bye.